Hello guys, welcome back once again, and in this video we will be seeing about how to upload a file using JSP and serverless. Okay, for that we need two more libraries to work with that. One is file upload and one is commons.io. I have shared the download link in my description. You can just go and check it out and download these files. And we have to add the common files upload and the commons.io libraries in our library folder, which presents in webbin and libc. Okay, let's move into the code. First, let us design a page for the file upload. We go create new JSP file upload. Okay, then we put an add form. Action equal to upload servlet, method equal to post. And we have to add one more parameter as mType. Type is equal to multi path or form data. Okay, so we have an input element as file. Input type is equal to file equal to file. Okay, sorry, we can specify this size also. Okay, next an upload button, input type equal to submit, value equal to upload. Okay, that's it. So we already have a user home page. I will give the link of this page over there. File upload.jsp. File uploading. Okay, so this is what. Now let us check this whether page is getting linked or how the page is like. So just run the index.jsp. From there we will go to the user home page and check whether the file upload page is coming or not. And the next step will be modifying some parameters in web.xml so that we will use it in the upload file servlet. Okay, now let us check. Login. So file uploading. Okay, this is what the is. We have to select the file. Okay, it's good. Okay, now let us go to our web.xml. And we have to add a parameter. Add context param. Description as file upload. Then param name as file upload, param value I can store it in network. I'm giving the location where to store the file. This is the path which I'm going to store the file. Okay, that's it. Now let us create the servlet as upload servlet. Okay, let's go to the post and start coding. So we need some variables to work with. Boolean part, string file part, then name max file size. It can be as some 5 MB or whatever it is. You know, make you some size, random size 2024. Then max mem size can be 2024. Then we have to use a file path where we are also going to store the file. So to we can use get servlet context dot get init parameter as file upload. So this will have the file path. Then we have to check it's multipath. Okay, so we'll be checking whether the form is a multipath form. So it's multipath is equal to servlet file upload. Now we'll be using the libraries which we have already downloaded. So servlet file upload dot is multipath content request. So we are checking whether the request is a multipath. Okay. Then we are setting the response as response dot set content type text.html. So let's set the reference for the print writer out object. Print writer equal to response dot get writer. Okay. Then if multipath do enter that by not load. Okay. So we can also return. We have to check if now we will be doing the process for uploading the file to the particular application. So this file item factory equal to new this file item factory, then factory dot set size set sold as max file size, then factory dot set repository for a temporary it's like a temporary repo to process the file. New file C temp. Okay. So we have to add the import at java.io.file. Then we'll be doing servlet file upload equal to new servlet file upload. we will be passing a fact tree, the parameter, then upload dot set max, set size max as max for itself. So with every declaration and the initial values have been saved right now, now we'll be processing the form. Okay, let me have a type that block. Okay. Then now we have to get all the items from the form. So list file items equal to float dot pass request. So we'll be passing the request. Then we have to need iterator to process the list. I equal to file items dot iterator. While I dot as next, we have to process whether the file is there. Okay, now we will be having a file item. From file of fi equal to I dot next. So we have to cast this to a file item. Then we have to check whether that particular item is a form field. What is the form field of the particular item? Not fi dot is form field. String field name is equal to fi dot get field name. String file name equal to fi dot get name. This is the file name. And string content type equal to fi dot get content type as a file item. This is the file item. And boolean is in memory equal to fi dot is in memory. Okay. Then we have to get the file size in bytes. So what I'm doing is long size in bytes equal to fi dot get size. Okay. Now let us start uploading the files to the particular location. If file name dot large index of is a array instead of greater than or equal to 0, so we will directly upload the file. File equal to new file dot plus file name dot substring. So we'll be getting the file name. File name dot source index of. Okay. Create a field here. File I didn't create it. Okay, I will be created. So let me create a field for file. Oh, my keyboard is not working. Okay. Now what we will do is go to the else part. So file is equal to new file. File path plus file name dot string. Of file name dot lost index of plus 1. So that's it. Then essay dot write file dot file uploaded. So we can give the file name as file. Okay, that's it guys. Now let us check this, how it's working. So let me run the project. Run as run on server. Let me give the username and password. Let's log in. Go to file uploading. Let me select a file. I have many files. Okay, let me select this CPT and I'm uploading it. So there is a problem. Okay, let us know what the problem is. So I think it's because of the file size which we have restricted here. Now let us try uploading the small files. File to small size. So this will be not uploaded. Okay. So let us try changing the file size, max file size. Okay. So now let us try uploading the file. Okay, that's it. So the error is because of the max, the restricted max file size. So the file. So that's it guys. Just like and subscribe. Thank you.